പ്രോഗ്രാമിലേക്ക് സ്വാഗതം. കഴിഞ്ഞ ആഴ്ച നമ്മളോട് അനുഭവം പങ്കുവച്ച പ്രിയയാണ് ഇന്ന് തുടർന്ന് നമ്മളോട് അനുഭവം പങ്കുവയ്ക്കുന്നത്. അതിനെ ഞാൻ പ്രിയയെ ക്ഷണിച്ചു.
I came to Bina. I came to attend was New India Church of God,
yeah, in so, Goa.
In Goa. So they brought me over there. I accepted the Lord. But that day sermon which touched me was
in the church.
Church, yeah. Like how I came closer to God was the verse from the Bible which said, "I will never leave you nor forsake you, even though your own leaves you, but I will not." So that really touched me and changed my life.
Because you are experiencing that,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. So that's what really changed my life.
Yeah.
And then I said I have to give my life to the Lord. And then I started coming to the church, New India Church.
Who was preaching that day?
Pastor Martin.
Martin.
So while reading and opening the books and all.
Yeah.
So this verse came. And it really touched me and it transformed me from that day. But that's where the transformation took place.
Okay.
And then my daughter was very small. I would come to the church along with her, go back. And then life was very difficult for me.
Okay.
So then I spoke to Bina, since she was supposed to start a care home for the children. So I said, "Bina, can you keep my daughter also?"
Yeah.
So she was there with Bethesda Life Center. I still remember there were very few children, and it was at Porvori. And boys and girls were mixed, and so every Sunday, whenever I used to come to church, they also would come to church, and then I would meet her over there and come back.
Yeah.
So it was a nice, but I always felt that my daughter Christy is only not mine, but those other children also, they always used to say, "Auntie, you come to see us, no? Why don't you this?" So, you know, the bond between not only Christy but even the other children made me feel very good.
Yeah.
So that every Sunday, longing to see children plus going to church.
Yes.
So that's how I continued. And
I also remember Christy as a little girl. Yeah.
Yeah. So she was very smart, very studious child. And then as years passed, then I started working with positive people, continuing with positive people. After positive people closed in 2007, I went to Lighthouse International Ministries. I was working as a warden over there.
Okay.
So daily 3 hours I would travel up and down just to support my child.
Mm-hmm.
And then eventually Christy became as she was growing, she found herself to be saying, "Mama, you're not spending time with me. Why did you bring me over here?"
Yeah.
And so slowly I told her, "Okay, I'll take you next." Then she was not getting, then she got this breathing problem. She started falling sick. So doctor said, because of her health is going down, don't take her back.
Mm.
And then she was with me in my rented house. That time I was staying in Agasai. So I brought her, and then from there she would go to school up and down daily. And then eventually I went to Margaon because I thought this was God's grace to me. I was doing for so many people, taking them to the hospital. The dead I was burying, the Hindu I was cremating. So nearly those years were like I was just on my toes, helping people, taking them to hospital, cremating them, burial and all. This was like on and off daily. There was
so you are so much involved.
Involved in it, yeah. And then removing their maggots, heal their wounds, everything, taking them to the hospital, everything in that one. This I was doing because the gist was there, that enthusiasm was there, saying that if I have faced this, no other one should face. So because of that, and then we would be fighting with our doctors, we would be laying some laws for the people who are positive, you know, really being active with them so that they should not. I know even in my life I have gone through discrimination where, you know, one day I was so tired and I went to my neighbor and I said, "Auntie, just give me one glass of water." And she said, "Yeah." And she brought in a nice crystal glass, she brought water and she gave me, and I drank and I said, "Thank you, Auntie." And she took that glass and in front of me she just threw it, and I'm saying, "Auntie, why did you break it?" "Oh no, 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 you have that disease, no, so it will come to me." And it was like, so, you know, it hurts.
Yeah.
So I said, "Auntie, disease and illness, who don't get?" So I said, "But this is not a contagious one and all." So then I left my husband's place also, I came this side. But God has been so good. that he's seen the goodness what I have done, and there I met a foreigner from UK, okay. And she was also diagnosed with cancer, okay. And I was at the end stage looking after her, and she said, Priya, you look very sad, please tell me, I want to help you, she said. I said, Chris, mom, I just want a small land, can you give me 100 meter? So she said, Priya, you see wherever you can, but those days I was not getting. So in 2006, I brought 380, she only brought and gave me, and I thank God for being so good, because if I didn't have a place, I do not know where I would go today.
Yeah, so you have a place?
She gave me a house, yes, I built, okay. And it is a RCC, it's not even this RCC build-up it is, of this, so I'm happy over there, and I thank God for being so good.
See, yeah, when you God. Ask the Lord in your life and started loving Him, the Lord told you, isn't it?
Yes.
I will never leave you nor forsake you.
True it was.
So how good God was in your life.
Yes.
Not only that, you are really serving. The service which so many people can't do. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but please tell me some experiences, some testimonies of the people whom you are
Like, you know, some are just broken, I get very emotionally, because I know I'm into that emotional phase only. But people who got, you know, this HIV and TB goes together. So most of the people die of TB or are infected with TB first. So, and cancer is a second killer, especially ovarian tubes for cancer for the woman, breast cancer for the woman.
Okay.
So these are women, but I still got a cancer patient with HIV still.
Okay.
She's still living, but her, this was just to support her, give her some gist. I said, don't worry, everything will this. And yesterday only I got a new case. New means her husband died 13 years back, but she was not ready to come for medicines, nothing. And then I told her, my girl, you have to start. She's got a son who's 25 years old. I said, no, you have to start, see. And then she's got brothers and sisters, but they are not talking to her and all. But she's saying, Priya, because you have motivated me, because you told me about this disease, because you are there by my side, because I went with her to the hospital, I took her to the center, I made her to do all her blood tests and all. She said, Priya, I'm ready to live now. So something, I felt
somebody should be there to motivate.
So I also felt, Lord, use me wherever you want. I'm not saying make me a great celebratory or nothing. Just where you want me, just use me. That's my prayer. And one thing, the Lord was always with me, because you know this disease is very scary, and people this. But I say, Lord, you make the way. Even that day when we came, everything the Lord put for us. It was just like, just go smoothly. We went to the doctor, we went to the testing, everything just opened for us. And I said, thank you, Lord. So my one, this is like, before going through these difficulties, I always say, Lord, you be with me. You show me the way. It is only you who can do it, because you are a God of all possibilities. That's what...
Now you have God with you.
Yes,
Even though there is nobody else.
Yes. Yeah.
When He is for you, who can be against you?
Yes.
Isn't it?
True. Yeah. So I really this... And every this, whether it is illness, I was very bad 1 year, and I got spine tuberculosis. I was paralyzed, fully paralyzed.
Oh.
For 4 months, I would go on my butt.
Is that right?
I could not walk. I could not sit. Even five steps, I'm going, I'm just falling. So I could not. And then I went to Bangalore. I didn't have money to go to Bangalore. Some Bangalore friends came to see me, who knew me about this disease and all. And they said, Priya, tomorrow you are going to board the train. I said, but I can't walk. I knew my sister, she took me anyhow, and I tried, and I sat in that Yeshwantpur Express. Anyhow, I reached Bangalore. But in Goa itself, for 6 months, I'm running up and down. No doctor could tell me what was wrong with me.
Yeah.
And it was spine tuberculosis what I had.
Whoa.
So the TB from my spine went to my chest. From my chest, it was just about to reach my brain.
Whoa.
So I was very bad. And Bina saw me. She came to see me. And she said, Priya, you look very bad. I said, no, Bina, I'm diagnosed with this. I said, go, Priya, to Bangalore and come back. And I went to Bangalore. They did the correct treatment. And I love the... doctors in Bangalore, they are so loving, they are so kind, they are so human. they will really encourage you. They never discriminate you. Yeah. They never. Whenever we go, no, they just hug us like, you know, any of our known people or any of our. That's what I like about
that. That's what we really need, isn't it?
Because I told when I was going for operation, I said, doctor, I went to the doctor and I said, doctor, I'm not walking for the last 4 months. I said, doctor, will I walk? He said, Priya, tomorrow you will walk. I said, doctor, why are you making fun of me? I said, don't make fun. No, Priya, you will walk tomorrow. I said, doctor, 4 months pass, I'm not walking. He said, okay, you don't worry. See tomorrow. And then he operated me after my TB disc. I had got slip disc. So my disc went off and then that's why I was paralyzed. If I would not operate, I would get fully paralyzed. But when I told the doctor,
right time, see how God leads you and guides you.
And the money was very costly, 2 lakhs he told me. I said, doctor, I don't have 2 lakhs. Yeah. Then he said, how much you have? I said, doctor, I have to go back and see, but I don't have that much, maybe 20 I might get. But tell me, God has been so good, and when I told my friends I'm going for operation, automatically money came.
Amen. Amen.
He came and my operation was 2 lakhs which came to just 1.25.
Okay.
1,25,000 only that doctor took. He said, Priya, I know your situation, I know your this, and I thank God for that. Because he was there with me, he stood beside me.
The word of God says, if you do my business, I will look after yours.
Yeah, yeah.
So you are doing his work, isn't it?
Yeah.
Entering the Bible says, we are anointed to heal the brokenhearted, to set the captives free. So you are mentoring so many brokenhearted.
So I thank God for that. Then I came back, I stood the very next day on my legs. I started walking and I told the doctor prior to that. And I like this something about this doctor. His name is Dr. Gauri Shankar.
Okay.
He said, I said, doctor, I'm diseased with HIV. Priya, that's not my business. My business is you get well, and it really motivated me. So I really salute him. Like, I really this. That's what gave me. I was thinking that no one likes me because of this disease. He just hugs her and he's saying, no, Priya, I'm not worried about your disease. I know how to take care. I'm worried you get better tomorrow. So that's what I really liked about
him. See, what's one word from a person.
Yeah.
If when it is negative, how much it affects us.
True.
And when it is positive, how much it boosts us.
Yeah. And so he always says to me, whenever I go, he says, Priya, you're a power of woman. You're a woman of power. That's why, you know, you can change so many lives. You can change so many people, he said to me. I really like this. He said, because I've taken a lot of people who can't be treated here.
Yeah.
In Goa, I have taken them to Bangalore.
Okay.
They have got better, they have got well, and they are still standing strong. That's what. No hopes. Everyone has given up hopes. I remember one boy, he was 22 years old, and he had, for 6 months, we are running here and there. He's saying, this is only paining, this is paining. And then I said, come on, just give up. No doctors telling what is wrong. So I took him to Bangalore, and the same doctor who operated me, I said, doctor, he's so-and-so disease. I said, don't worry, Priya. But what's wrong? I said, he's getting very low-graded fever. These are symptoms of TB, he said. But I have not seen. He said, do an MRI. He did this part MRI. Mama, I'll tell you, this boy had abscess inside that part of his pelvic area inside.
Wow.
2 liters of pus was removed.
Wow. How much pain he would have gone through.
And we, mother, myself, are just roaming here and there to see what is wrong with this boy. But that doctor then operated, and I really, this 2 liters of pus he removed me, and he said, and this boy is still living. He's now 25 years old, and he's still going strong. His viral load is gone high. His CD4 is gone high. So I really have a this for him, because he's the only son of his mother. And he's also diagnosed with this disease.
Oh.
So I always say, Didi, you saved my life. I said, not me, because he sent me to serve, help you, I said. Because I've not this, I said. So they all, many in my life, I have saved many who have really, when no hope was given to them, I have saved their life.
Yeah. The ladies who come here, you know, broken hearted and everything. So when they accept the Lord, their lives are changed.
Changed. Yes, yeah. That's what. So if my life can be changed and this, so I want each and every this who have gone through similar situations in their life to come back to the Lord or to know who is the Lord and what He can do.
Yeah.
That's what. And now still going on. So then after that, I joined Bethesda Life Center. And we have this sunflower meeting, support group.
So how long you are serving with Bethesda Life Center?
Last 4 years.
4 years.
Okay.
With working with Bina.
Unofficially 25 years I'm with Bethesda.
With Bina. Only you got saved.
So that's what. I'm under this because I'm getting a salary. But unofficially I'm 25 years with this. I remember also working with this. We have the project for women, so where we call all the women together once in a month. So we have medical support for them.
Okay.
So one doctor.
These medicines are working for the HIV.
Yes. So there is free of medicine now. So now there was only first line, second line. Now third line has also come.
Oh.
Because if you're a failure in first and second, the third can work on you.
Okay.
So now still one is not come. It is an injection that is called infusion inhibitors.
Okay.
That will come only, but that is very costly. It will be costing 1 lakh. So that is only one injection per year.
Okay.
So it could but there are a lot of side effects to these medicines.
Okay.
So taking these medicines can destroy your kidneys, destroy your liver. So it can be a lot of harm to you. But if you eat good food, if you really eat good food, no tension free, then you should be very active, you should not recall. So I think you can live really 30 to 40 years with this disease. So no problem.
So anyway, after medicine came, people are living
home. Yeah. So in 2005 Goa medicine started.
Okay.
Yeah. But prior to that, when I started in Bangalore, so we were not started from here. So we just continued from here.
And then what else you do here?
Here then I take the people who are sick to the hospital, to the
OP. And when they come for the meeting,
Once in a month, so we have the doctor coming.
Is it?
Yeah, for the because see, when your immunity is low, you can get a lot of infection. So a doctor comes to see if anyone got infection, so he gives medicine for them. Then we have this praise and worship. We sing some songs together, praise God because He still kept us alive. And then if we have any issues, we speak in between us, like any problem we are facing with our doctors or with the we have a pass for HIV, so if anyone is facing any this with the pass holders, if they are rejecting you, and so it is free for us.
Okay.
So that one government has made. So all the schemes, if anyone has got all the scheme, widow pension scheme, HIV scheme. So we talk about there, or anyone is not well and need to be home visited. So in that we talk, and if anyone is facing discrimination, any child is being thrown out of school.
So they have somebody to talk to. And console. And you give them food?
The food, like if there is we give them some snacks. Food is only maybe on World AIDS Day or Women's Day, some celebration day we give them. But first it was daily because but now financial.
How many come altogether?
We have around about 80 of them coming. So 80 registered is around about 215 registered. But half.
And you go to the, from here they selected some cell group leaders and and they go to the slums.
We have one more worker with me. She's a field worker.
Okay.
So she works in Vasco because in Goa, Vasco is a area where there are a lot of these way people. So she works in Vasco and she goes to their houses to see their health. They're taking their medicines and all. And then every Friday we meet and we ask anyone needs any attention, anyone needs help for medication or anything. And that's how we discuss between ourselves. And also for this meeting, Bina gives them loan for all those who are unable to be stable, you know, like, you know, if they are finding financially this. So Bina gives them some money.
How much you give?
10,000 per.
How many you have given?
So total now we have given 37 loans.
Oh.
Yeah. 37
So the, what they do with that?
So they have their own businesses, or they create some business for them for sustainability, so yeah. that they cannot be dependent on others. So some of them have goat farming, some of them have chicken, like a very small small scale industry. This
but
like,
with that they can make a living.
Something, yeah, some living of them. Okay. So then is some of them ready-made garments, some of them were making those this crochet towels and very small this. So whatever they get, they would...
So then now they are, their lives have changed.
Yeah.
When they met Jesus, isn't it? ഞങ്ങളെ കേൾക്കുന്ന പ്രഷർ എനിക്ക് പറയാനുള്ളത് ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ സ്നേഹം അതാണ് നമ്മളിവിടെ കണ്ടുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നത് കേട്ടുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നത് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അത്ര എളുപ്പമാണോ എച്ച് ഐ വി പോസിറ്റീവ് എയ്ഡ്സ് ഉള്ളവൻ്റെ ഇടയിൽ പോയി പ്രവർത്തിക്കുക എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ കർത്താവിൻ്റെ സ്നേഹം എന്നെ നിർബന്ധിക്കുന്നു എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ പോലെ ഇവിടെ പ്രിയയും ബീനായും ഇവരെല്ലാം ഒരുമിച്ച് ഒത്തിരി ഒത്തിരി ആവശ്യം ഉള്ള വ്യക്തികൾ ഈ എച്ച് ഐ വി പോസിറ്റീവ് വ്യക്തികൾ ഈ ഗോവയിലുണ്ട് അങ്ങനെ ഉള്ളവരെ കണ്ടുപിടിച്ച് ഞാൻ നേരത്തെ പറഞ്ഞല്ലോ അവർക്ക് വേറെ ഒരു പണി അറിയത്തില്ലായിരുന്നു ഈ പ്രോസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷനിലാണ് അവർ ജീവിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരുന്നത് എന്നാൽ അവർ വരുന്നു അവർ രക്ഷിക്കപ്പെടുന്നു രക്ഷിക്കപ്പെട്ട് കഴിഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ ഇപ്പോൾ പ്രിയ പറഞ്ഞല്ലോ ഇപ്പോൾ 37 പേർക്ക് അവർ 10,000 രൂപ വെച്ച് കൊടുത്തു എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ അവർക്ക് വേറെ ഒരു ജോലി അറിയത്തില്ല അവർക്ക് എന്തെങ്കിലും ചെയ്ത് ഇച്ചിരി പൈസ ഉണ്ടാക്കണം അപ്പോൾ ചിലർ കരിക്ക് വിറ്റായിരിക്കും ചിലർ പച്ചക്കറി വിൽക്കുകയായിരിക്കും ചിലർ ഈ ടെക്സ്റ്റൈൽസ് എടുത്തുകൊണ്ട് വന്ന് വിൽക്കുകയായിരിക്കും അപ്പോൾ പറഞ്ഞല്ലോ ആട് കോഴി ഇങ്ങനെയുള്ള ഈ 10,000 രൂപ വെച്ച് വാങ്ങിച്ച് സ്വർഗത്തിലെ ദൈവം അതിനെ അനുഗ്രഹിച്ച് കൊടുക്കുക ബീനാനോട് പറയാണ്ട് ബമ്മ ഇട്ട് അവരെനിക്ക് ദശാംശം കൊണ്ട് തരുമെന്ന് അപ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് അവർ പറഞ്ഞ് ഞങ്ങളെ ദൈവം അങ്ങ് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുകയാണ് അപ്പോൾ എന്തൊരു ഡ്രമാറ്റിക് ഡ്രാസ്റ്റിക് ട്രാൻസ്ഫോർമേഷൻ അവരുടെ ജീവിതങ്ങളിൽ കർത്താവായ യേശു ഈ ലോകത്തിൽ വന്നപ്പോഴും അല്ലേ ഒരു ശമര്യക്കാരത്തെ തേടിപ്പോയി അവളോട് പറഞ്ഞ് എൻ്റെ അങ്ങനെ 5 ഭർത്താക്കന്മാരുണ്ടായിരുന്നു ഇപ്പോൾ ഉള്ളതൊന്നും ഭർത്താവല്ല അപ്പോൾ അങ്ങനെ ജീവിക്കുന്നൊരു സ്ത്രീയെ എന്നാൽ അങ്ങനെയുള്ളവരുടെ അടുത്താണ് കർത്താവ് പോയി അവരെ രൂപാന്തരപ്പെടുത്തിയെടുക്കുന്നത് ഒരു മണ്ഡലക്കാരത്തെ മാറിയ 7 ഭൂതം ബാധിച്ചവൾ അനേക ഭൂതങ്ങൾ വിട്ടുപോയി വേശ്യാവൃത്തിയിൽ അവനെ കണ്ടുപിടി അവളെ കയ്യോടെ പിടിച്ചു എന്നാൽ കർത്താവ് അവർക്ക് വേണ്ടി നിന്നു നിങ്ങളിൽ പാപമില്ലാത്തവൻ അവളെ കല്ലെറിയട്ടെ അപ്പോൾ യേശുക്രിസ്തു ലോകത്തിൽ വന്നത് നല്ലവരെ തേടിയല്ല പാപിയെ തിരഞ്ഞു രക്ഷിപ്പാൻ ഇതുപോലെയുള്ളവരെ നമുക്ക് അതിൻ്റെ ഹൃദയമുണ്ടോ നമ്മുടെ ചർച്ചയിൽ കയറി വരുന്നവർ ഏറ്റവും നല്ല വെള്ളം ഷർട്ട് വെള്ളസാരി ഒക്കെ എടുത്ത് ഏറ്റവും ടോപ്പ് രീതി വരുന്നവരെയാണ് നമ്മൾ സ്വീകരിക്കുന്നത് എന്നാൽ ഇങ്ങനെയുള്ളവരെ ഉൾക്കൊള്ളാൻ ഇങ്ങനെയുള്ളവരെ സ്നേഹിക്കാൻ അവർക്ക് ഭക്ഷണം കൊടുക്കാൻ അവർക്ക് ലോൺ കൊടുക്കാൻ ഇതാ കർത്താവ് നമ്മളെ വിളിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത് നമ്മുടെ വാക്കുകൾ പ്രിയ പറഞ്ഞല്ലോ ആ ഡോക്ടർ നല്ല ഒരു ടെസ്റ്റിമണിയാണ് അവൾ പറഞ്ഞത് പുള്ളി പറഞ്ഞു നിന്നിനക്ക് എയ്ഡ്സ് ഉണ്ടോ ഇല്ലയോ അതൊന്നും എനിക്ക് വിഷയമല്ല കെട്ടിപ്പിടിച്ച് അവളെ ആശ്വസിപ്പിച്ച് ധൈര്യപ്പെടുത്തി അതാണ് കർത്താവ് നമ്മളെ കുറിച്ച് ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നത് ഒരു നല്ല വാക്ക് പറയാൻ അത് അവൾക്ക് ഇത്ര സന്തോഷം നൽകും എന്നാൽ അവളുടെ കണ്ണിന് മുമ്പിൽ ഒരു ഗ്ലാസ് വെള്ളം കൊടുത്തേച്ച് ആ ഗ്ലാസ് എറിഞ്ഞു പൊട്ടിച്ചു നമ്മളെന്താ ചെയ്യുന്നത് ഈ നിലയിലെ കർത്താവിൻ്റെ ഒരു പത്രമായി നിലകൊള്ളുവാൻ കർത്താവ് നമുക്ക് ഇടയാക്കി തീർക്കട്ടെ യേശുവേ അതിനെ സഹായിക്കണമേ കർത്താവേ നിനക്ക് വേണ്ടി നിൻ്റെ നാമത്തിൽ നല്ല പ്രവൃത്തി ചെയ്യാൻ നിന്നെ സഹായിക്കണേ എന്ന് നമുക്ക് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം യേശുവിൻ്റെ സ്നേഹം കൊണ്ട് മാത്രമേ നമുക്ക് ചെയ്യാനൊക്കത്തുള്ളൂ എൻ്റെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ ഇങ്ങനെയുള്ള ഒത്തിരി പേരെ സഹായിക്കാൻ എനിക്കിടയായിട്ടുണ്ട് പക്ഷെ ഓൺലി ത്രൂ ദ ലവ് ഓഫ് ക്രൈസ്റ്റ് ആ സ്നേഹം വരണമെങ്കിൽ യേശു നമ്മുടെ ഹൃദയത്തിൽ വരണം ഇതുവരെയും യേശു നിങ്ങളുടെ ഹൃദയത്തിൽ ഇല്ലെങ്കിൽ ദയവായി ഒരു വാക്ക് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കും യേശു എൻ്റെ ഹൃദയത്തിൽ കടന്നു വരണം ഇവരെയൊക്കെ രൂപാന്തരപ്പെടുത്തിയ കർത്താവ് എന്നെ രൂപാന്തരപ്പെടുത്തണം എന്നൊരു വാക്ക് പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചാൽ മാത്രം മതി യേശു നിങ്ങളെ സ്വന്തമാക്കും യേശു നിങ്ങളുടെ ഹൃദയത്തിൽ വരും നിങ്ങളെ അവൻ്റെ പൈതലാക്കും ആ യേശുവിലേക്ക് നിങ്ങളെ ആഹ്വാനം ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ട് എൻ്റെ വാക്കിൽ നിങ്ങളെ വെച്ചു
ഈ പ്രോഗ്രാം നിങ്ങൾക്കൊരു അനുഗ്രഹമായി തീർന്നു എന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എന്തെങ്കിലും പ്രാർത്ഥന വിഷയങ്ങളോ അപേക്ഷകളോ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ഞങ്ങളുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെടുക ഞങ്ങളുടെ മെയിൽ വിലാസം ന്യൂ ഇന്ത്യ ചേർച്ച് ഓഫ് ഗോഡ് ബെതസ്ത കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കേഷൻസ് ചിങ്ങവനം കോട്ടയം ഫോൺ നമ്പർ 0481-243-0329. Mobile number 944-75-78202. Website www.mariamathampi.in. Email address mariamathampi@yahoo.com. അടുത്ത ആഴ്ച ഇതേ സമയം വീണ്ടും കാണാം. ദൈവം നിങ്ങളെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കട്ടെ.